gospel mail.
Amen. Hallelujah. Where's the Tylenol? Welcome to the Bronson Church. I'm Pastor David Mayfield. This is Deacon Paul Kovac. And we're going to do some...
Only the sixth pastor of the Bronson Church. Sixth or fifth?
Sixth, I believe. Since
1839.
That's right.
I haven't been here since 1839, but I'm only the sixth pastor since 1839.
It's amazing that each one of those pastors lived to be 104.
Yep.
And kept preaching the whole way.
And each one was hairier than the last.
That's a good sign, David. That's a good sign.
I think it's the healing tap water in Peninsula.
Over in the glory land.
Hey, let's go there. Singing all kinds of weird notes on that one.
The good Lord was moving you in unique sort of ways. I'm having a little trouble with my banjo this morning, David. I don't know if it's the weather or whether it's something else.
Could be some kind of hex or a curse that was put on you and your banjo by some
a demon got in
demonic
there?
Woman.
I don't know about the woman part, but
we don't. One thing we don't allow in the Bronson Church is demonic women. There's a sign right above the door.
There's a woman in the church.
Got pain on her face.
We're going to do that one of these days.
All right, one of these days.
I wrote up some good lyrics for
in this
one.
Little white church.
Yeah, I think one of my strings is kind of telling me something.
Well, just tear it off there. You got four more.
Three and a half more. Well, if it sounds like I'm playing through some kind of fuzz pedal, that's the reason why. Okay. I'm not really doing that.
Blame our sound man.
Always
blame the sound man. That's the general rule of performing anyhow. When you screw up, just blame the sound man. Well, the little white church in the valley, if there was ever a, this is for you because you like this one, and the Bronson Church.
It's a little white church.
And it's
in the valley.
It's in the valley, peninsula. I'm going to do a little turnaround, a little kickoff turnaround.
What key do you want to put this in for the people at home?
I think if everybody tunes to G, we'll be all be really close to one another.
Grab a hold of this, everybody. Ready?
There's a little white church in the valley that stands in my memory each day. And it seems I can hear the bells ringing, though I am many miles away. Church on Sunday morning, that whole countryside would gather there. They would all kneel down by the altar as they lifted up their voices in prayer. Oh, that church in the valley, that little white church is a place I love so well. Now I'm sad and lonely, I'm sad and lonely for that little white church in the vast ages, oh Christ, let me hide myself from thee. And I know some of them are now waiting just over the dark and stormy sea. I know that troubles now have ended, and happy forever they will be. They are waiting and watching up yonder. Church is a place I love so well. Now I'm sad and lonely, I'm sad and lonely for that little white church in the valley. Well, I'm sad and lonely, I'm sad and lonely for that little white church in the valley.
We did it.
We haven't sung that one in a long time. I'm going to set the banjo up.
Always putting the banjo down. What will he pick up next?
I'm going to do the old Bronson guitar. You've heard of Bronson cigarette lighters, David?
I have.
No relation to this church whatsoever.
They weren't invented by Charles Bronson? Herman Bronson.
Herman Bronson is the Bronson of Bronson Church, when he's the first pastor?
No, his brother Abraham came back from Connecticut to be
a... Abraham, now that's a gospel name.
Abraham. He's that man right over there in the mall. And right back here is Herman and his wife.
Wow.
He came from Connecticut. He was the man who planted all of the lots and peninsula from the Western Reserve land.
Oh, wow.
Deal. Yeah,
he was a surveyor.
Yep. He built the stone house across the street. That's the Bronson House, and then he built the Bronson Church.
Oh, no kidding.
Because all those men who worked in that stone quarry, he thought they were lawless and women grabbing men, and he thought they needed someone in the church. So this is the first church in the world.
Oh, it didn't work.
18.
Look what we got now.
Look what a mess Peninsula has become. just a den of
a debacle-ish hole in the ground. I'm putting cornstarch on my hand, David, because I suffered from the lack of cornstarch last time we played here.
Well, I told you that would happen if you didn't quit.
I know, but I'm back. You want to sing this one, or you know this song?
You take the lead, and I'll jump in.
You sure?
I don't want to take. No.
Take anything away from you.
No, I have nothing left for anyone to take away.
He left it all.
I've lost it all.
I'm thinking maybe E might be a good key for this one.
I'm thinking you're right.
Let's want to find out.
Let's see. We're in this together.
This one's called The Darkest Hour. It's just before. Thank you.
before dawn.
Sung that one a long time.
I like that.
I like that too. Yeah. Jesus' feet. That's kind of the short version of it.
Yeah.
If you don't have time to say the darkest hour is just before dawn, you just write down Jesus' feet.
Jesus's feet. That's a good place to lay your soul.
Burdens down.
Yeah, that too.
Well, turn the page, David. Let's see what we're going to play next in the hymnal.
It's actually Turn the Page by Bob Seger. Down a dark and lonely highway, in the east of Omaha, there's some din and a turning.
That might be my favorite joke you said yet.
Thanks.
That's the first one you got.
That's true, man.
Yeah.
I'm a simple man.
Dave Garrett. You know Dave Garrett? He's like a Northeast Ohio singer. Boy, that was his.
Is he in the band Limited Edition?
He might have been, yeah. His brother Dan Garrett.
Oh, yeah, I remember them. From Garrettsville.
Or should be. Yeah, boy, he used to own that song. Still probably does. Well, want to try a little call and response number?
If you call, I'll respond. I don't know how.
You've been responding already a few times today, David. I mean, are you feeling the spirit? You seem to be, your voice seems to be unearthly, unhumanly, just kind of going in all kinds of directions.
Thank you, Paul.
And I mean that in the most genuine, sincere sort of way.
Well, I think I'm probably filled with some kind of holy birthday spirit.
Holy birthday spirit.
Yeah.
When, your birthday?
Not my birthday.
Karen's birthday?
No.
Ben's birthday?
I'm surprised you don't know.
Yeah, I know. It's
let me know.
He doesn't know.
We had a bet that you'd mention it within the first 10 minutes of being here today.
Today is the 13th.
September 13th. Think about what happened on September 13th, 1911. I don't know. It might be the wrong year. It's Bill Monroe's birthday.
Oh, how about that? Now would be a good time to do a Bill Monroe song.
After all that, it sure would. Too yeah, bad we don't know any.
You're right. It was a 1911.
Instead, let's do a Danny Jones and Paul Kovac song.
Yeah, but we learned this from Bill Monroe. So this is a good apropos. We stole it.
Stole it. You heard it here first. And if Bill Monroe was alive, he'd take you to court because he was very litigious.
He'd say, I'm glad I could help the boys out. Help them out with their, give them a start, give them a leg up.
He'd say, Lester, get your hand off Earl's knee.
All right, flip this one over and we'll get her going.
All right.
Lord, lead me on.
Day to day,
I want to walk the holy way.
friends forsake me all alone. But I ask the Lord to lead me on.
Lead me on.
That's a good one right there.
That is a good one. There's this song. I can't remember the name of it. I think Hazel Dickens did it. Lori Lewis put it on her Hazel Dickens tribute album. Something about
that song?
They used to pray and her sister. Do you know what I mean?
Well,
might need a little more.
Yeah, when you talk about, like, you know, praying and my sister, that doesn't narrow the field a whole lot. May as well throw mother and brother.
And I'll do a little research and get back to you.
There you go. That's right. A little gospel research. One thing I've got to remember is, like, well, let's do this one just like this.
Sure. Where'd you first hear this song, Paul, that we're about to do?
I learned this from the Hot Mud family.
The Hot Mud family. Sounds like SpongeBob characters.
they were my go-to band, and I remember as a Ute in Chardon, Ohio, holding a Hot Mud Family, which was kind of an old-timey and old-time bluegrass band with a great gospel, great trio of singers in it, and holding the Olden and the Way album in the other hand, going, these are the only two albums I have, and there must be something in between these two records. And what I realized was the entire spectrum of bluegrass fell between those two records pretty much.
Yeah.
But yeah, they used to sing this song. They had great choice in picking their bluegrass material. And this was one of their gospel songs. Where'd you first hear this one, David?
I first heard this from the band Tasty Licks.
Oh, yeah.
Jack Tottle and the young 17-year-old Bela Fleck.
Keep going.
Playing banjo on that record.
And who was the guitar player and lead singer?
In Tasty Licks?
He went on to become a famous lead singer for
Bob Seger.
Again, Bob Seger again.
And Lord from Highway. It's a callback.
Pat Enright.
Pat Enright. Oh,
Pat
yeah.
Pat Enright. And
Nashville Bluegrass Band.
Right.
Fame.
Who spent a little time in Cleveland, Ohio as well. He went to the Institute of Art, I think he told me one time. He lived on Mayfield Road, he said. Wasn't Mark Schatz the bass player in that band as well?
I don't know. I don't know if he was on this record, because I don't remember seeing his name.
Huh. Research. We'll have to add that one to the research pile.
But you know who's been doing this song a lot recently is Rhonda Vincent in The Rage, and I saw her Labor Day weekend.
Really?
Perform live in the human flesh.
Where'd she perform? Where'd you go,
Labor? I went down to Sam Jam Bluegrass Festival in Piketon, Ohio. Where everybody was safe. We all were fighting COVIDs together. And I took two or three down myself. But got to see good blues. Seldom Seen was there. Doyle Austin and Quicksilver.
Wow. All the big bands.
Yep.
And you performed there with your band?
I just
hung out, had backstage passes, and
yeah, I mostly just, you know, pulling pranks on people,
tying shoelaces
together, and that sort of thing. But Rhonda did this song.
Well, good for her.
Yeah, it's a good one. It's called "You Don't Love God If You Don't Love Your Neighbor." Full title, right?
Right.
You want a little mandolin?
Yeah, a little. I want you to do the old flip flop on it again.
All right.
Good message right there. Now, David, honestly, truthfully, have you ever gone into the Holy Bible, to the book of Matthew, to the 18th chapter, to the 31st verse, and read what that special warning is?
I have. If I remember correctly from my studies to become a preacher, the warning is don't eat the yellow snow. I could be wrong. It's been a while. It's
loosely translated.
That's in the NIV version. Yeah.
Some things get lost in translation when you're translating from the original language of the Bible, and that's probably yours got a little bit twisted around a little bit.
The Bible was originally written in West Virginian, right?
One of the hardest dialects to translate.
That song was
Who will sing for me?
No, who will sing? That's a good one, though.
That's the Lori Lewis song you were talking about?
Yeah.
Well, bless her heart. Oh, that's the Hazel Dickens tune.
Yeah.
Who will come and sing for me? Yeah. We'll take a little of this. What can you do to sing?
See? Mm-hmm. Trouble, and only he against the devil. You were no stranger to the rain. So go rest high on that mountain. Son, your work on earth is done. Shouting love for the Father and the Son. Left us gathered round your grave to grieve. I wish I could see the angels' faces when they hear your sweet voice sing. Son, your work on earth is done, and go to heaven and shout in love for the Father.
Karen likes that song.
Oh, well, that.
That's
a powerful number.
I believe he had the Spirit on that one.
Vince Gill wrote that song about Keith Whitley, who shuffled loose the mortal coil way too young.
He was a good one.
Powerful.
I hear a little Keith Whitley in your singing.
Well, I sure listen to a lot of him.
It rubs off on you.
Well, let's see here. Paul's getting the gospel banjo back out.
With the demon D string.
That's
oh,
right.
My
He's
goodness. Wait a minute. It's the D string, and it starts with D, and so does the devil. I'm going to tell it to run and hide its face.
We might have our first ever televised, streamed Bronson Church banjo exorcism.
We might need it.
The power of Christ compels you
to raise your action in
race.
All right, here's one I never got to sing with Bill Monroe. What key do you want to do this in? G?
Wherever you want. Tell me to go.
Know.
I'll follow.
Sinner, run and hide your feet. Run to the rock. Let's take it easy on ourselves. We'll just do it right there.
Sure.
Crying holy to the Lord.
where Moses stood. Said, run and hide your face. Run and hide your face. Run and hide your face. Hide your face. Rock, brother, rock and hide your face. Rock cried out.
Oh, rock cried out. No hiding place.
Crying, holy unto the Lord.
Holy unto the Lord.
Holy unto the Lord.
Crying,
holy unto the Lord.
Holy unto the Lord.
Holy unto the Lord. If I could, I surely would stand on the rock.
Stand on the rock
where Moses stood. Sinner now, crying, holy unto the Lord,
holy unto the Lord,
crying, holy unto the Lord,
holy unto the Lord,
holy unto the Lord. If I could, I surely would stand on the rock,
stand on the rock
where Moses stood.
Ain't no stranger
now. Ain't no stranger now. Ain't no stranger. I've been introduced to the Father and the Son, and I
ain't no stranger now.
Crying, holy unto the Lord,
holy unto the Lord,
holy unto the Lord, holy unto the Lord. If I could, I surely would stand on the rock,
that big old rock
where Moses stood.
Boy, just like we practiced that ending.
Oh, right? All those years and years of practice.
Makes perfect.
Yep.
Ben, let us know when we're getting close to the end of our hour, okay? We don't. Neither one of us have a gospel clock with us here.
We should all make a wish. What'd you wish for?
Oh, was I supposed to make a wish too?
Yeah. My wish was that Paul would tell one of his classic gospel jokes.
Craziest thing.
That's what Ben Gage wished for too, everybody at home.
Really?
BenGage.com.
I wish for world peace.
All right, so we're 50-50. Half of the entire congregation wishes for
world
my gospel joke, and the other wishes for world peace.
Maybe your joke can bring world peace.
No pressure.
Yeah. Well, Forrest Gump dies and goes to heaven. And there he is at the pearly gates. There he is at the pearly gates, and St. Peter says, well, you know, there's been a lot of mayhem in the world, and things are getting kind of tight up here. We can't just take everybody for face value. You kind of have to go through a little bit of a three-question air. He says, well, okay, I think that'd be okay. And so St. Peter says, first question is, how many seconds in a year? And he says, well, that's easy. It's just 12. Second of January, second of February, second of March. So, and St. Peter says, well, oh, I guess I have to let that one go. All right, how many days of the week start with T? And he says, well, that's easy, just two. And St. Peter says, yes, today and tomorrow. St. Peter says, well, I reckon I have to agree with that one as well. He says, but all right, so he's trying to keep him out of heaven. That's the idea. You know that. And he says, all right, Forrest, here's the last question. What's God's first name? And he thinks for a second. He says, well, I know that. It's Andy. Andy? He says, yeah, Andy, I heard it in a gospel song one time. Andy walks with me and he talks with me and he tells me I am. Thank you all so very much.
Welcome wishing you world back, peace. Everybody. That joke literally brought world peace.
That's right.
To the Bronson. Yeah, that's a good one.
That's a good song, though.
It is. Maybe we ought to work. It's a good waltz number.
Yeah.
You can't dance in the Bronson Church, but you could play a song in four times.
You can dance at home. A lot of people are watching this at home in their underwear.
You don't know that they're at home.
Oh, yeah, I do. We can see. And look, if you look into the camera, you can see out of their computer. See?
Oh, yeah, you're right. Man, some people have a loose definition of underwear.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, well, let's do this old Monroe Brothers in honor of Bill Monroe's birthday. I'm so happy. I don't know why I woke up. I was feeling kind of grumpy this morning, and I'm really happy now that it's Bill Monroe's birthday. That means 11, that means how old would he be if he was still alive?
Oh, he'd be at least in his 50s.
He'd be pushing. He'd be one of the old guys.
She's praying to Andy from now on. Just so you know, Paul, you changed the world, right?
You're changing things.
Changing the world one heathen at a time.
Uh-oh.
Oh,
we're in E.
I was thinking E, maybe. Would you?
Soul for the things that decay. Oh, if today God should call you away, what would you give in exchange for your soul? What would you give? What would you give
in exchange?
What would you give in exchange for your soul? Oh, if today God should call you away, what would you give in exchange for your soul? The dear Savior to tenderly plead. Risk not your soul, it's precious indeed. What would you give in exchange for your soul? silver and gold on this earth. More than all jewels, the Spirit is worth. God the Creator has given His word. What would you give in exchange for your soul? What would you give
in exchange?
What would you give
in exchange?
What would you give in exchange for your soul? Oh, if today exchange for your soul. Oh, if today God should call you away, what would you give in exchange for your soul?
That's good. I like that one. That's a good one.
I believe you were channeling Bill Monroe on that one.
Yes, sir. Oh.
Yikes.
Come to that part in the hymnal where we both get a little scared. It's a song that we have never done in the Bronson Church before, or any church for that matter.
Or any non-church.
That's right. But this is a good, you know, a lot of people who tune into our stream, they might pray to the God of Abraham, but not follow that hippie Jesus. And this, we could send this one out to them. This is an Old Testament song.
That's right. And a lot of good stories. All the good stories come from the Old Testament.
Oh, there's some good stories in other, like 50 Shades of Grey. That's pretty good. You mean just Bible stories?
God, Bible,
yeah,
stories.
Okay.
Yeah. You want to do this one, Acapulco?
We might as well.
Let's try this one. So we'll try this one without instruments, except for reference, tonal reference.
Ancient tones?
Buddy, I'm going to get me a little sip of gospel water here.
Hey, holy water.
Well,
the healing
Kirkland water.
Well, we refilled all of these with water straight out of the Cuyahoga River.
Woo, Dougie.
You can use it as lighter fluid.
It's best not to drink the water downstream from Akron, but you know, we got no choice. It's better than the tap water. So I hear. So my good buddy, Rafe Stefanini, one of the best fiddle players in the entire world, he's from Bologna, Italy, and he has speaks beautiful Italian, and he's a great traditional musician, and he says, a cappella. He says that means as in the chapel. So we think of a cappella meaning without instruments, but in the chapel, they sing without instruments. So that's actually the Italian translation of a cappella. Have I stalled long enough?
No, that's good. This will be on the test.
Go to www.bronsonchurch.com/test.
/ Angels Fire GeoCities.
I don't know why I like this game. Heard about a man one day who wasted not his time away. Prayed to God.
Oh, Nanny prayed every morning,
noon and night. He cared not for the things of man. He trusted one who would not fail. Oh, Daniel prayed.
Oh, Nanny prayed every morning,
noon and night. Oh, Daniel served the living God. While upon this earth he trod, he prayed to God.
Oh, Daniel prayed every morning,
noon and night. He cared not for the king's decree. Trusted God to set him free. He prayed to God.
Oh, Daniel prayed every morning,
noon and night. They cast him in the lion's den because he would not honor men. He prayed to God.
Oh, Daniel prayed every morning,
noon and night. The jaws were locked, it made him shout, and God soon got them safely out. Oh, Daniel prayed.
Oh, Daniel prayed every morning,
noon and night. Oh, Daniel served the living God. While upon this earth he trod, he prayed to God.
Oh, Daniel prayed every morning,
noon and night. He cared not for the king's decree. He trusted God to set him free. He prayed to God.
Oh, Daniel prayed every morning,
noon and night. Now, brother, let us watch and pray. Daniel did from day to day. He prayed to God.
Oh, Daniel prayed every morning,
noon and night. We too can gladly, daring do the things that God will take us through. We pray to God.
Oh, Daniel prayed every morning,
noon and night. Oh, Daniel served the living God. While upon this earth he trod, he prayed to God.
Oh, Daniel prayed
every morning, noon and night. He cared not for the king's decree. He trusted God to set him free. And he prayed to God.
Oh, Daniel prayed every morning,
noon and night. That's a lot of praying.
Ooh.
All right.
Every morning, noon and night.
That reminds me of another joke that you honestly don't tell in church.
And let's leave it at that.
It's not a bad joke, but it's not one you tell in church. Well, I bet you we're getting close to the end of the gospel hour here, David.
Well, we're at the end of the gospel hymnal.
Yeah, 4 minutes.
Got 4 minutes. Okay, well, that's 2 minutes of preaching and 2 minutes of picking. I'd like to let the folks know. I'm going to play this on the band.
Oh, my goodness.
We've decided on a schedule for the... the Bronson Church Gospel Hour. We should have a better name than the Bronson Church Gospel Hour with Pastor David Mayfield and Deacon Paul Kovac. It should be a little shorter.
I think it should be called the Bronson Church Gospel Show Church at the Church of the Bluegrass.
Bronson Bluegrass
Revival. Bronson Bluegrass Boys Bringing Back Bluegrass American Great
Boo.
But when are we doing? We're doing the second and fourth Sunday.
And you know what I was thinking? We should do one outside, shouldn't we?
We should do one outside. And the people can come and socially distance themselves.
We could
make a square. And maybe you can have a few guests.
Well,
yeah. Could you live stream that too? Outside?
Yeah, we could do it. We could do it in the first or the second one in October.
We'll have to get sunscreen for Ben.
Yeah, I'm fair.
If we do it outside.
He is fair.
Yeah, we totally could make that happen.
Well, I'd say we better do it quickly if we're going to do it outside because time's running out. It's already September.
Let's go outside right now.
Next week, the following week?
You mean the next time we perform here? That's, 2 weeks.
Yeah, Daniel's running that stream, but he could do it too.
So again, for the people at home, the second and fourth Sunday of every month, we'll be here.
And on your intranet dial.
Yeah. You can find us by watch, but we're doing whatever you're doing right now. Let's do it again.
I call my girlfriend and say, how do you get that thing again up on my computer? And she helps me out. Yeah, so maybe by the time, how many people in the congregation today?
Eight-oh. And then after the jokes, it kind of
quickly shot down.
Anywhere between 8 and 8.
That's right. Our show was for anyone from 8 to 80. Well, you know, let's finish off with this one. This seems like an appropriate kind of song because the Western United States is on fire.
That's right.
And the Southern United States is getting hammered by storms of water. And I'm not sure what exactly the rainbow sign is, but I'm hoping it means that the rain's going to stop and the winds are going to stop and people are going to get their lives a little bit back. This is all amidst, talk about Old Testament. These are like Old Testament kind of
things.
Yeah, fire. And
you know, on my drive to the Bronson Church this morning, I was literally raining frogs.
Really?
Just thousands of frogs were falling from the sky.
That's biblical.
Yeah.
That's old school testament.
We are facing a catastrophe of biblical proportions. But here's a song.
I saw a grasshopper in my driveway yesterday. Just one, though.
That's pretty.
It starts with one.
That's the first one. We'll see how many are there when I get home. So on behalf of Pastor David Mayfield.
And Deacon Paul Kovac.
We'll say God bless y'all in any way, shape, and form that you hope to be blessed. And we'll see you in 2 weeks. And email your gospel requests. And if we already know them, we'll probably do them.
Sure.
Pretty much.
And if you got any money that you need to get rid of, you can donate to Voices in the Valley.
Build that new addition to the GAR hall.
That's right.
Every penny counts.
You know, we're also looking for somebody who would want to sponsor this and then put your ads for your business.
Oh, yeah. You want to sponsor? We're at the Bronson Church. We're going commercial. Selling out. This could be the Budweiser Bronson Bluegrass Hour.
Eddie Stubbs show in Washington used to be the Eddie Stubbs Roto-Rooter Hour. So we'll take, in other words, we'll take anybody as a sponsor.
Don't you see?
Don't you see?
Stand west, fire and roll. you see? East and west, five will roll. Be with my poor soul. Tied me over Rock of Ages cleft for me. God gave no rainbow sign. Don't you see?
Don't you see?
God gave no rainbow sign. Don't you see? God gave no rainbow sign. Won't be water, be fire next time. Tied me over Rock of Ages cleft for me.
Take care of yourselves and your neighbors in the meantime.